Hey guys, your boy Cooper here, and welcome back to my 516 Liverpool Crime where last time I left off, I gave Man City the beating of their professional existence. And boy, was it sweet. But I'm not here to talk about that. I'm not here to talk about the Liverpool game in this past week. Again, I know you probably all were expecting me to talk about that. But you know what? There's something else that needs to be addressed. A little known cunt by the name of Fernando Torres. Oh yeah, I saw that news story. We betrayed him, did we? Did we really? Oh, you handing in a transfer request. Basically, he's saying you wouldn't play until you got your high price move to another team. Oh, that was our fault, was it? That was our fault. Bullshit! Sorry, just had to cough there. Sure. Wait, so like I said, bullshit. Oh, wait, that's because I did. What a unbelievable old bullshitter her little prick Fernando Torres is. You know what it is? He's mad. You know why he's mad? Because Liverpool, he probably thought to himself, Liverpool will fall without me. What did we do? We didn't fall without him. We got a little known player by the name of, Luis Suarez. Don't know if you met him, he's 10 times better than you on his worst day. And Luis Suarez brought us within an eyelash of winning the Premier League. Now, immediately, we finished second one season when Fernando Torres was our main striker. But we got closer. We were actually top at some point in the... It actually looked like it could be our year when we had Suarez. Even when we were top, when we had Torres, no one even thought... Not even us Liverpool fans, a lot of us were saying, we're not going to win the league. Imagine. You know how I know that? Because that was my reaction. So, Fernando Torres is trying to put the blame on someone else. Okay. You know why your career went down the toilet? Here's what you do. Who would find the culprit of that, Fernando? Stop being a crybaby little bitch, go to your nearest bathroom in your big ass fucking 50 million mansion, go into the bathroom, look in the mirror, and you will see the culprit of why your career went down the shitter, yourself. Simple as that. You've no one to blame but yourself. We didn't betray you, you betrayed us. You sign a new contract, and then all of a sudden, you refuse to play until you get your move. But didn't Liverpool have the last laugh when we signed a player who was better than you?
That's an easy interception.
Granted, we signed one who was worse, but Suarez made more than made up for Andy Carroll. And Suarez has proved himself to be far better than you could ever dream of being. And it was so sweet watching your career go down the shitter as you missed open goals. You couldn't make up which team you wanted to play for. You were Atletico Madrid, then AC Milan, then Atletico Madrid again, and back to Chelsea. Mostly back to Atletico Madrid. And what happened to Atletico Madrid? You didn't play well. Maybe one game. And, they released your stupid ass on a free transfer. little Suarez. Oh yeah, he's one of the best players in the world now and plays for Barcelona in the most dominating attack in world football. Oh. So again, we got the last laugh. So Fernando, instead of blaming us, how about you blame yourself? Get off your fucking ass and try and get a new team. Good luck with that, because that everyone sees you're a little whiny bitch, and anyone has seen you the past couple of seasons already know you're shit. Now, you've lost your touch. No one, and I mean no one, will be ringing you up to sign you up. Ha ha ha. Go. Oh. Oh no. Up to your lonely 50 million mansion, you whiny little prick. You can try and blame us, but we had no say in your downfall. Mate, it was all on you.
Well, the referee is sick.
That felt good. That was therapeutic.
Can Liverpool make a good first half?
Then my not really frustrations. I don't know what to call that. Well, I guess you could call it venting the truth. I was smacking my knee because I had nothing else to smack.
As blocks go, that's a good one.
Man, the truth hurts. The truth hurts. Heard someone get Fernando Torres a 50 million ice back because he's gonna need it for that one.
Here's a chance to show how good they are at corners and maybe increase their advantage.
So, what else could I talk about? I don't want to go into it. You know, I don't want to... Normally, when Liverpool play a game, I go over everything in bad detail, and I probably bore the pants off of you non-Liverpool fans watching this, for whatever reason.
Liverpool will get the throw.
Oh, just find me entertaining. Could be a case. I know. Well, I watch a lot of FIFA YouTubers who are not Liverpool fans. This is they're entertaining. I'm not gonna go too long with the talk about the game between Liverpool and Arsenal. I will say one thing. Alberto Moreno, run. Just run. Because everyone in Liverpool is now planning to kill your stupid Spanish ass. And you may as well run anyway, because you will probably be hopefully never play here for Liverpool again. Well, I don't know. It's not looking good. It's not looking good in terms of assigning a left back before the Burnley game.
Shot off, and a goal into the bottom corner.
So, you might get one more game, but all in all, you're going to be replaced.
Cristiano Ronaldo, and he couldn't have took that in.
I mean,
any more accurately and hit with real power.
It's just common sense.
It's given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway.
And I mean, this is not the first time you've tried to completely screw us over. Oh boy, we got enough of that last season, so we're not playing up with your shit again. So, you might get the game against Burnley, but trust me, before the end of the window, before the
direction.
the Spurs game, we'll have a new left back. And he'll replace your ass because, hell, the dude passing buck. He out there, or as I look out my window, well, he could replace Alberto Moreno. Oh, you need a training because Alberto Moreno is that fucking shit. But yeah, offensively, Liverpool were very, actually really good. Especially our main man, Phil Pitti. Yo, well, I mean, what a free kick. I don't care who you support, you have to give the props for that free kick. It was just masterful. And here comes the counter-attack. Shots on here. Oh, great work by the keeper. Great work by the goalkeeper. Great hands. One. All of Liverpool's goals were really good. Our defending leaves something to be desired, which is no surprise. I have already explained why I thought but the defense was going to cost us the game against Arsenal. Luckily, it didn't, despite Alberto Moreno's best attempts.
Well, I don't go that far from the holidays.
But yeah, oh no, a good win, despite the every 5 minutes almost having a heart attack when we thought Arsenal were going to score. Earning steal point. Well, not really steal point. I mean, they were the better team in the first half. It was just in the first few minutes of the second half was when Liverpool turned it on. And then they quickly, promptly turned it off again because, of course, they are Liverpool. They have to do that every game. It looks like they're going to win comfortably or they wouldn't be trademark is the worst team to watch when you support them in the Premier League. Purely from a visual standpoint, because, you know, 4-1, you think, oh, that's 1. Oh, 4-2. Oh, no problem. 4-3. Uh-oh. Not this shit again. Yeah. That's a cut. If you're not a Liverpool fan, you don't know. And if you are a Liverpool fan, you're like, oh, don't even start. So, that's all I'm going to say on the Liverpool win. I'm glad they did win, but I could do without the constant heart attacks. So, yes, Jurgen, please sign a left back. Now, see, something has caused issues or something. There's maybe like an issue over fee or something. Something has not gone according to plan. We are still. Ooh. We haven't gotten whoever we're trying to sign over the line just yet. And it looks like we're not going to get them in before the Burnley game, unfortunately. But hey, that's okay. That's okay. That's okay. After the Burnley game, it's fine as long as we don't do anything stupid in the Burnley game. Simple as that. No? Simple as that, right? That sounds easy enough, right? Right? Right. Yes. I'm not in agreement with myself. Anyway, the game ends in it. My third Champions League match, it seems like it only started the group stage in the last episode. I seem to be flying through the group stage matches. Maybe it's because I do 2 videos a week and it's about to become 3 because I'm almost finished. Arkham City, and I'm actually almost finished Brooklyn. They both should be finished in their next video, so yeah, you're gonna see a lot more FIFA very, very soon. Oh, joy. And don't worry, the schedule will change a little bit. Because I realize, since Batman is currently taking up the Friday video slot, that would mean you'd have two Marseille Kurumo videos, and then two Liverpool Kurumo videos, and another Marseille Kurumo video, then another Liverpool Kurumo video, and the last Assassin's Creed video. But after Assassin's Creed Brotherhood is done, I've perfectly lined it out where you won't see the same career mode 2 days in a row.
This is the Liverpool side.
Well, I guess I can. So here is how it's gonna run.
Point to that diamond, Martin, behind the two strikers. He's important.
The secondary career mode will get 4 videos, and the main career mode, which is the Liverpool career mode, will get 3. Monday will be the secondary career mode, which as of right now is, of course, Marseille. Then Tuesday will be Liverpool. Wednesday will be Marseille again. Thursday will be Liverpool, so that's not changing. Friday will be the secondary career mode, Saturday will be Liverpool, and then Sunday will be the fourth video in the secondary career mode. Now, Sunday is going to be the day that I use for other games when they come out. When they come out, Sunday is going to be the day that I set aside, so that way, okay, I get all, I can keep all the career mode in perfect harmony, E3 and 3, and the Sunday video, which because of the 7-day week, is the extra career mode video for the secondary career mode. And why is the second? Now you're probably saying to yourself, why is the secondary career mode getting more videos than the main career mode? Well, purely because, you know, that way I can get the secondary career mode done faster. I mean, my main focus will be on the Liverpool career mode, so it doesn't really matter how fast. It's not like I'm trying to cram all a whole bunch of secondary career modes into one, whole bunch of different teams into the career mode. It's always going to be Liverpool. Also, that's why the secondary career mode, up until a new game comes out, will be the game. Will be
well. The shot's on. What a fine save.
The
strong, powerful.
Will be, you know, what have you? Will be the that'll be the schedule until something new comes out. Now, unfortunately, there's nothing new coming out this year that really interests me to the point where I want to make a playthrough on it, so you're probably going to be stuck with a lot of career mode. Now, I might be dead. Now, hopefully I'll be returned. I will be getting an interview for college very soon, so
you won't want to lose his place in the game. And
when that occurs, I will be going back to the court every week. Pre-recording.
He's one of the best finishers around. They don't want to lose him. Well, now they've won the ball back in the middle of the park by intercepting that pass.
Now that I think about it, it'd actually be kind of easy to prove. Or when you're, when I don't even have to change the game that I'm playing.
The players were
just have to. Yeah, actually, I just thought how I will do that. That's quite brilliant, if I do say so myself. And you really don't need to know how I'm gonna pre-record. I mean, unless you want to. Oof, you do. Well, I can explain it, but it's really just, you know, stand for stuff. What I'm gonna pre. If you think about it, it's not too complicated. It's not too groundbreaking. It's not like I've come up with a groundbreaking way to. Oh, that was too close. Whoo. As I was saying before, then it almost scored. Freaking hell, it cut that way too close. As I was saying, it's not like I've come up with a brand new groundbreaking way to pre-record. It's very simple when, you know, probably only have to think about it for a minute. There's probably all of you, some of you already going, oh, wait, that would make sense. And finally, Jesus, I was wondering where this goal was coming. All the first half, I couldn't score. Out of nowhere. Equilanti. He scores. That's another goal. That's 6 Champions League goals. He's been very good. Good. I mean, when you consider how little I paid for him. And it's actually ironic, because it's the number on the back of his jersey. It was 21 mil.
Wasting of time in that situation.
It's actually really funny. Because he's been amazing. I don't know why Chelsea, he sold him to me so cheap. If he keeps this up, he could be an actually 50 million player. Who would actually deserve the valuation of 50 mil. Unlike a certain Spanish striker I'm not going to name again. Or I could just name him his new name, Crybaby. Oh, and thank you for the penalty, Zenit. It's me, Neto?
It's a yellow card for the offender, and it's
oh, he's joined in the book as well, Luis Neto.
Looking again, Alan.
Is that not very happy? Huh? Their number 13 found my number 13. Yay!
That will be a corner. The referee has.
Damn it! Keeper saved it. Guess the right. Wait, quick. Oh, it didn't matter. Or the resulting corner is nodded in by the big German lad of Jonathan Tah. Great header from Shea Ojo to put it on a platter, and he just nods it in. Oh. In it goes, and the fans go crazy. Brilliant.
The away team want to make a change. And here comes the counter-attack. Oh, the relief to get that. That looked a chance.
Well, he missed the ball there for Plenty.
So far,
there's
9 shots.
Collett.
Well, the opposition keeper. This is how they love to play on the break.
Hello?
Very good tackle.
I cuts me off. Danilo! Oh, it's a screamer from the center defensive mid. Oh, what a top quality finish. The poor pass leads to the goal. I tried his, I'm gonna say his best. Kind of just like,
given them a
I don't know if that's the best he could have done to try and prevent that goal, but hey, your way. It is 3-0, and I am going on to 9 points. I will be only one win away. See, this is what I wanted from the Marseille second team. They only picked up in like the last game. And after countless formation changes and personnel changes.
He's moved in trying to jostle the opponent off his stride. And it will be a kick for the goalkeeper, goal kick.
This second, my second team, no matter who's in the lineup, no matter how I line them up, they normally get the job done. Well, there's not been a case when they haven't got the job done. And Aquilante, you can stop celebrating, you're offside, kid. There we go. Yeah. Finally, he stopped. I wish there was like a way to stop your player celebrating when you know they're offside. Because I saw the flag, like, which is why I didn't say anything.
Cleared the ball.
I'm not making it 4-0, because I knew it wasn't 4-0.
It is about making decisions in key areas of the game.
That was a poor shot to pull it. But it's 3-0. Oh, getting close to the end. And so it's not going to truly matter. So we'll get rid of that. I just realized both my center backs are German right now.
That's a fine tackle.
Sewell in the top.
It's a quick break.
Danilo gets away from Garay, makes it 4. Or just to wrap it up, why not? Danilo grabs the second of the match to finish off Zenit. 4-0.
It's just arrowed into that right hand side of the goal.
Pretty much almost guaranteed. He's not just qualification for the next round, but that will almost guarantee he finishing top of the group, because Zenit were in second place. You'd be forgiven for not remembering that, because they didn't play at all like they were in second place. They had one chance at the in the first half, but they almost snaked in, but didn't happen. And the other game finished 1-1. That is beautiful. Just for some of you wondering why that is beautiful, I will show you. So let me. Come on. There we go. Ah, there we go. There it is. The group stage. With 3 games remaining, I'm already 5 points clear of Zenit. And they're in second place. I'm 7 clear of Orza. And PSV. Who should be finishing above Warzar, or bottom of the group. But look at that. Look at that domination. That's all the second team. That's how good and reliable they are. So, in the next Champions League game, I will finish off the group. Sage, as another youngster signs a new contract. But that next group stage game is not in the next episode. In the next episode, I have Barnsley in the cup, but before that, I have a league game against the real life Premier League champions, the Foxes, Leicester City. Oh, my next game is against Liga, so they have to beat me to stop me from getting qualification. And if, for some reason, PSV, say if PSV beat Zenit, now I know, considering they have 1 point from three games, but you never know. If PSV actually were to beat Zenit in that game, in their game, I would win the group in that. In the next set of games, which will be, oh, that'll actually be next Thursday's video. Actually, hang on. I'm trying to think. No. That'll be before I finish Brotherhood. No, wait. Yeah, Thursday comes before Friday. Dirt. So yeah, don't miss Sunday's video, and don't miss next Thursday's video, because they're both going to be must-see. As I it will hopefully extend my lead over Chelsea at the top of the league and with my league games, I hope to advance in the Capital Cup, because of course I always do win a little in the cups, aiming for the quarterfinals against Barnsley. The second team will do their job as they did in this episode. And next Thursday, you'll see me play again against the Wolves. And the crucial game, where if I win, I'll be guaranteed my spot in the knockout stage of the Champions League for the fourth season running. So yeah, thanks for watching. I enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Hit subscribe. New to the channel, so you don't miss the next episodes in this career mode. Or than any other videos that I might do. Until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day.